Hi students, welcome to our maths class. This is class 12th and I am Harshnath Shukla. And today we are going to discuss the exercise 2.2, rest question of exercise 2.2. So up to 6 we had already discussed. So question number 7, we are going to discuss the simplest form, okay? So, question number 7, see, question number 7, okay? So, in question number 7, if you see, we have to write it in the simplest form. Tan inverse of root of 1 minus cos x upon 1 plus cos x. Okay, this is a very good question. So simply, and x is less than pi. So simply, if you see, if you write the formula, half angle formula, then it is tan inverse of root of 2 sine square x by 2 and divided by 2 cos square x by 2. You know the half angle formula in class 11, as you know very well, okay? So this is tan inverse of 2 cancel out. This is tan square of x by 2. And you know this is tan inverse of tan x by 2. So this is simply x by 2. So this is the answer. This is the simplest form of this question. Okay. So please note it down. Okay. Now see question number 8 one. Question number 8. Okay. So this is tan inverse of cos x minus sin x divided by cos x plus sin x. Okay. And 0 is less than x is less than pi. So that is very simple. See, tan inverse, if you take cos x common from both, otherwise in other word you can say dividing numerator and denominator by cos x, we will have cos x upon cos x 1, sine by cos tan x divided by 1 plus tan x. You know very well how it will be. If you divide by cos x on numerator and denominator, then cos x divided by cos x, this is 1. And minus sin x by cos x, this is tan x. Cos x and plus sin x, this is 1 plus tan x. And you know, this is the formula for tan inverse of tan pi by 4 minus x. You know this one? Let us explain. Okay. First you write it. Tan pi by 4 minus x. How it will be? 1 can be written as tan pi by 4 minus tan x. 1 plus 1 into tan x, that is tan pi by 4 into tan x. So tan a minus tan b upon 1 plus tan a tan b, this is tan pi by 4 minus x. And this is simply nothing but pi by 4 minus x. And this is your clear. Okay, so again I explain you, tan inverse cos x minus sin x upon cos x plus sin x, dividing numerator and denominator by cos x, you will have 1 minus tan x upon 1 plus tan x, and this is nothing but formula for tan pi by 4 minus x. So this is tan inverse tan pi by 4 minus x, and this is nothing but pi by 4 minus x. Simply this is the answer. Okay. Afterwards, question number 9. So, first you note it down. Okay, 9th one, you see. Question number 9th. Tan inverse of x upon root of a square minus x square. As you know, I will already told you, whenever you see in square root a square minus x square or 1 minus x square, then always you suppose x is equal to either a sin theta or a cos theta. Okay, so here we suppose let x is equals to a sin theta. Why sin theta? Because tan is there, so if upside is sin theta, then this is may be converted in tan theta. And from this, if you see x upon a is equal to sin theta, so theta is nothing but tan inverse of x by a. Okay, and afterwards you put here x is equal to a sin theta, then this becomes tan inverse of a sin theta divided by square root of a square minus a square sin square theta. So this is nothing but tan inverse of a sin theta divided by a square 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, so after this step I will continue. First you note it down. Okay, whenever you note the question, you pause the video and note it down. Okay, so next we see. Tan inverse of a sin theta upon, this is a outside of the square root and this is 1 minus sin square theta cos square theta. So this is tan inverse of a sin theta divided by a cos theta, and this is nothing but tan inverse of tan theta. Okay, so it is simply theta, and you have already the value of theta. Theta is what? Sin inverse x upon a. So this is the simplest form for that question. Okay, so please note it down, and afterwards last question, this is 10th one. Okay, so we will see. First you note it down. So I hope you completed this one also. Now question number 10th. Okay, what is question number 10th? See, tan inverse of, question number 10, tan inverse of 3a square x minus x cube divided by a cube minus 3ax square. Okay, in this question, if you suppose let x is equal to a tan theta, then obviously theta is equals to tan inverse x by a. As you see here already, theta is equals to tan inverse x by a. Why? Because x upon a, this is tan theta, so theta is what? Tan inverse x by a. Okay, now if you put x is equal to a tan theta, this becomes 3a cube tan theta minus a cube tan cube theta divided by a cube tan cube theta divided by a cube minus 3a cube tan square theta. Now this is nothing but tan inverse of, if you take a cube out of the bracket, this is 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by a cube here also 1 minus 3 tan square theta. Okay, so a cube cancel out. Clear? And after this step, what will we have? So let us note it down, and then after we see. Okay, so pause the video and note it down. Okay, see, and afterwards if you see, we will get tan inverse of 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta and you know very well this is the formula for tan 3 theta. So this is nothing but tan inverse of tan 3 theta. So this is nothing but 3 theta, and as you know x is equal to a tan theta, so theta is nothing but 3 times tan inverse x by a. So this is your answer. Okay, so up to question 10, this is simplest form. Okay, we had to find its simplest form, and afterwards there is new instructions. Find the values of each of the following. So question number 11, we had to continue. So first you note it down, and then after we continue question number 11th onwards. Okay. Okay, I hope you completed this one. Now question number 11. What is question number 11? Tan inverse of two cos two sin inverse 1/2. 2 cos 2 sin inverse 1/2. Okay, this is the bracket here. First we find the bracket. Bracket is this 2 cos 2 sin inverse 1/2. Clear? So what do you think about this question? How will we solve? First we apply 2 sin inverse x. Okay? And then we apply change in cos and then tan. So tan inverse of 2 cos 2 sin inverse x, this is nothing but sin inverse 2x under root 1 minus x square. You know very well. 2 sin x cos x. If you see the trigonometric formula, sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. Simply sin inverse x is what? 2 sin inverse x in the form of sin inverse. What it is? Sin inverse of 2 sin inverse x cos inverse root of 1 minus x square. Okay? So, if you want, you can see the example number 3 on page number 45. Sin inverse 2x root of 1 minus x square. This is 2 sin inverse x. Okay? 2 sin inverse x is nothing but sin inverse 2x root of 1 minus x square. If x is less than, minus 1 by root 2 is less than, x is less than 1 by 2. So there is 1 by 2, that means we have used this formula, 2 cos inverse x, sin inverse x, okay. So first one, sin inverse of 2x, 2 into 1 by 2 and root of 1 minus x square, that is 1 by 2 ka whole square. So tan inverse of 2 cos sin inverse 2 cancel, this is 1 by 4, so root 3 by 2, okay, root 3 by 2, see 1 by 4 and 4 minus 1, 3 by 2, root 3 by 2. So again sin inverse can be converted into cos inverse, so tan inverse 2 cos inverse of root of 1 minus 3 by 4. Okay, so tan inverse 2 cos inverse, this is 4 minus 3, 1 by 2. So tan inverse of 2 cos inverse 1 by 2, 2 into 1 by 2. So 2 cancel, because cos inverse 1 by 2 is what? 1 by 2 simply. So tan inverse 1, and this is nothing but pi by 4. Okay, so match the answer. Question number 11, exercise number 2.2. Question number 11, exercise number 2.2. C question number 11. See the answer, pi by 4. Okay, so you may understand this one. First we convert this to sine inverse 1 by 2 by using this formula. 2 sine inverse x is equals to sine inverse of 2x under root 1 minus x square, as you see in example number 3. And afterwards this sine inverse can be changed in cos inverse interchange. That means transformation, sine inverse x, cos inverse root of 1 minus x square. 1 minus x square, 3 root 3 by 2 square, that means 3 by 4. And then after 2 cos inverse 1 by 2, this is cos inverse x, x simply. So 2 into 1 by 2, this is tan inverse 1, and tan inverse 1 is nothing but pi by 4. And now for today's lecture, last question, question number 12. And afterwards we will see in next lecture, okay? So question number 12. Maybe you completed this one. Now question number 12. Cot tan inverse A, cot inverse A. Very easy question. Cot tan inverse A plus cot inverse. If you apply the simple formula, then it is very easy. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is what? Pi by 2. See simply, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is pi by 2. So cot pi by 2 is what? This is cot 90. Okay. So what is the value of cot 90? If tan 90, this is infinite. So cot 90 is 0. So see the answer, match the answer, exercise 2.2, question number what, 12, this is 0. And afterwards there is only 21 questions, okay? So we'll see next lecture from 13 onwards, and then some miscellaneous example, miscellaneous exercise. So maybe one or two more lecture is required for this particular chapter. And I have to give answer also, and PDF also I send you. So whatever doubts you can clear, and please try to understand this particular chapter. This is very important for the differentiation, that means calculus, integration also. So please try to understand this chapter very well, okay? So thank you for today. Thank you very much.